Wake Forest destroyed NC State. They only had an 8.5 spread going into it. And I've been reading a lot of stuff on that game from NC State's side of things. And even the NC State writers were kind of surprised that it was only an 8.5 spread, because Wake Forest had been really throwing all over people. And NC State has a laundry list of injuries and doesn't really know what quarterback they're going to use from week to week. But Wake Forest came out and destroyed them 44-10. Now, I'm seeing a lot of things out there in the Twitterverse saying that Clemson needs to be worried about Wake Forest. They don't need to worry about NC State. They need to look ahead. I don't think Clemson needs to do that by any means. But do you think that that November 16th game in Death Valley is going to be a difficult one?
You know, I don't really think so. I haven't bought into Wake really all year, and I'm still not buying them. You know, I still think they have a decent offense for sure. I like what their quarterbacks are doing. Their receivers are doing a pretty good job. But I want to throw you out some defensive stats, all right? I kind of took a page out of your book here, all right? And I kind of want to ask you a question. I'm gonna put you on the spot here. All right, do you know the first best defense that Wake has played this year? Any idea who that is?
The best defense that Wake Forest has played this year. I'm going to say it's definitely not Boston College. maybe Florida State, maybe. I don't know.
Actually, Florida State was my guess. That's what you said, right? Florida State. You kind of went out on me there.
I'm guessing Florida State.
Yeah. Actually, it's NC State. Is the best defense Wake has played. And I really ask that to ask you this. Give me the second best defense they played. Okay? I know you're not going to know the answer, so I'm just going to go ahead and tell you. It's Rice. Okay? Total defense, Rice is the second best defense that Wake has seen all year. Okay? So I'm not saying they don't have a decent offense, but I looked up total defense stats today, and that's what I had. I think Rice is ranked like 62 or something like that. All right, that's the second best defense they've faced all year. I think that's why they're getting some of these points, okay? So when they rank Clemson, when they play Clemson, who's ranked number 4 on defense, I think that's going to pose them some problems, okay? And the best offense they faced, Boston College. So color me skeptical that they pose Clemson a huge threat in this game. Now, in fairness, you know, nobody saw the 2016 game against Pitt coming either. So you never really know what can happen. But according to the stats, according to what I'm seeing, I just don't see it happening.
Yeah, I think Jamie Newman is a great player, don't get me wrong, but really all that Wake Forest can do is pass the ball. People in chat are saying, where's their running game? Nobody knows. They don't really have it, but they are able to destroy people through the passing game. They do, on average, put up 510 yards. Most of it is passing, and 38 points per game. But on the flip side, it's kind of similar to that Boston College type of defense or Louisville type defense, where not only do they put up a ton of yards, but they also give up a ton of yards with 400 yards. Yeah. So we had this like device that would shut off all cell phones in the Army. So when you drove by, anybody in that radius in the radius of the Hummer, their cell phone would be shut off. And so nothing would work for them. And I liken that to the Clemson defense. Boston College, before Clemson comes in, racks up 400 something yards rushing. All of a sudden, Clemson rolls into town, nothing. The game right after that almost gets 500 yards rushing. So it's like all of a sudden their cell phone starts working again. All of a sudden their game plan starts working again. Same thing with Louisville. Passing like crazy, top 6 offense in the nation, duds. Clemson walks away, they start getting back in the passing game again. I think it's going to be the same thing with Wake Forest. Coach Venables goes in there, shuts everything down, says see you later, and walks out, headed to the ACC championship game. It would be a big deal if Clemson lost that game, because then it would be 2 1-loss teams over in the Atlantic Division, which would be kind of scary. I don't know how that would really work out. I guess Wake Forest would go in at that point, but that's definitely something Clemson will not allow or cannot allow.